Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning, the old cookbook show. Today, we're going to do a recipe out of this cookbook. This is a 1943 printing of the Canadian Cookbook, a very influential cookbook in Canada, first published in the 1920s, 1923, and pretty much published continually into the 1960s. This is a 1966 version of the cookbook. Julie and I have a couple of these. I came with one and Julie came with one. So we've got two copies. And it is a cookbook, if I may use a little bit of hyperbole. Every household in English-speaking Canada had a copy of this cookbook from one of the publishings. I know that's hyperbole, but you sort of get my point. It was a very crucial, critical, successful cookbook in Canada. And I would categorize it as a living cookbook. It was a cookbook that, with every printing, recipes were added, recipes were taken away, corrections were made, the changes were made to reflect changes in Canadian society, changes in the way Canadians lived, changes in economic times, you know, the hard times during the Depression, a lot of Depression recipes. Coming out of the Depression, post-World War II, world's looking pretty sunny, rosy, the recipes start to change. By the time you get to the 1960s, the recipes reflect a much more multicultural Canada. And not only that, the recipes in this version from 1966 are much more detailed. In the 1940s, 1930s, 1920s, this book assumed that you already knew how to cook, that all you were looking for were lists of ingredients, and maybe just a little bit of help if the method had a couple of twists and turns to it. So what we're going to do today is called lemon cookies. And you can see, quite clearly, it says mixes plain cookies. You pretty much knew how to mix cookies. I know how to mix cookies. So I've got the butter in the bottom of the stand mixer, and we're going to cream that together. And once the butter has softened up, we'll put in some white sugar. And we'll cream together the butter and sugar. And here I've got some all-purpose flour, and to that I'm going to add salt and baking powder. And we'll just give that a little bit of a stir together. And when I look through the 1966 version of this cookbook, there's so many recipes in there from my childhood. That is sort of the framework of our weekly eating in our family. So many recipes that I recognize. Next in, I'm gonna put one egg. So we'll get that in there. And then it calls for the zest of one lemon. So I'll zest this lemon up. And every once in a while, someone on YouTube does a video on the proper way to use a zester or to zest this type of fruit. The proper way is whatever's comfortable for you. I've worked in lots of professional kitchens with professionally trained people, and I've watched them argue over the best way to use this, whether you do it this way so that all of the zest stays on top and then you dump it in, whether you do what I did into a bowl and then dump it in, or whether you do it right into the bowl. There's no consensus. Everybody has their own way. Just do what's comfortable to you. So I'm gonna put the lemon zest in. Should add some really good flavor. So this cookbook, the Canadian cookbook, was very influential for a lot of Canadian households. Where you live, what is that cookbook? What is that cookbook that you would say defines your childhood? That is filled with, this is gonna end up on Cocktails After Dark. It'll be juiced later today and used in the cocktail recipes. What is the cookbook that you would say your mother or grandmother got most of her recipes from? I would love to know that so that I can search out some of those cookbooks. I may have them in my collection. Like I know in French-speaking Canada, La Cuisine Raisonnée is the one that is probably in the top two or three. And I've got a few copies of that over the years, and I should probably start cooking from them a little bit more. This looks good. Let's put the flour in. So I'll just put it in, spoonful at a time, let it mix most of the way or all of the way in before you put the next one in. Don't overload the bowl. Okay, so I licked the beater, and I have high hopes for these cookies. They taste pretty good. Now, I'm supposed to drop by the teaspoonful onto a buttered baking pan. I'm going to use a little ice cream scoop, and I'm going to use parchment paper on my baking sheet. I like parchment paper better than buttering my pans. And I'll be very careful with my portions so we can get small cookies. They're meant to be small cookies. It asks for a hotter oven than usual for a cookie, 375 rather than 350, and a shorter cooking time of 8 to 10 minutes. So I'll get these onto the sheet, and we'll get them in the oven. Okay, last cookie. And into the oven.
Woo, cookies! Hey, friends! Hey, Glen!
Now, these three in the end, I got them too close together. They did spread out.
I can start with those.
I've got really good flavor.
That's a really nice lemony flavor.
Yeah.
I really like that.
It's a soft cookie. It's not a crisp cookie. It's not a chewy cookie. It really falls apart in your mouth.
It's lemony, though. Mm-hmm. I do like it.
Really lemony.
Mm-hmm. You could put, oh, it's, oh yeah. You really don't need to add more sugar to it, though. As much as I'm like, oh, it'd be really good with some strawberry jam with it.
Some sugar sprinkled on top, maybe flatten them out and put some before you bake it. Anyway, super, super, super simple cookie. I mean, there's nothing to that cookie.
Cookies don't have to be complicated.
And I kind of really like it. That's all of them.
Oh, it's even a nice small little recipe.
That's it. That's all of them. You're not, you know.
So in one tray, you're done.
You're done. It's over.
Excellent.
You're done. So this, if you like lemon, is a winning cookie. Thank you to Nellie Lyle Pattinson in the 1943 Canadian cookbook. Give this one a try if you like lemon cookies. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.